Hello everyone, Ni hao. Thank you for coming for my session. My name is Kenji Shimono from Japan. This session is hacking Intel Windows tablet and mobile devices on Debian. Today, my presentation is in this content, 1 to 11. This presentation material is slide share and PDF publication on my website. Please read it. I will talk to three main contents. Point one, Atom UEFI. Point two, mainline kernel and driver. Point three, bootloader and UEFI boot entry. And the other. And this is my...
Sorry, can I just adjust your microphone a little bit?
This is my yoga tablet by Lenovo Corporation, and this is Debian Buster operated touch screen and Wi-Fi and the other devices. Thank you. And this is self-introduction. My pen name is Kappa, and this is Twitter account at website, SlideShare, and Facebook. And I have been active in Tokaido Linux users group on Japan, and hacking Linux on GPDB and GPD Pocket and other many devices. And I have about 100 Windows tablet and 30 Android tablet testing now. And this is recent my activity. Point one, Linux distro on Intel Windows tablet. Point two, machine learning on Linux on Python. Point three, Linux distribution on IM Android. And point four, presentation in Asia, open source conference. And this session is install Linux on smartphone and tablet. What is tablet? Do you think? And I think tablet have touch screen, battery, USB accessories, and some sensors, and fast CPU and GPU. This purpose, Linux distro on smartphone and tablet for next generation. And non-PC younger user can use and know Linux. And play your own Linux on tablet for Linux distributor. And this is a Debian presentation. Today I will talk about Debian on Intel tablet, Windows tablet. I want to say one sentence. Debian is most advanced Linux distribution on tablet because it supported multi-architecture library and UEFI 32-bit and 64-bit now. So, all of Windows tablet operated on Debian now. And this is mobile devices on PC market. Today I will talk Red Circle, Windows tablet, and Windows notebook PC, and the other Intel devices, and some ARM devices today. And today, Windows tablet is two inexpensive devices and in Japan and Akihabara. Let's install Linux distribution. Because all Windows tablet is not supported driver after Windows 10 creators update. So after Windows 10 creators update, they will not support and selling junk grade on manufacturer. very inexpensive. And important, used or junk Windows tablet is more inexpensive than Raspberry Pi 2 and 3 now. But CPU power is 3 and 4 times as fast as Raspberry Pi 3. This is Windows tablet versus Android. And Windows tablet is more inexpensive and easy to install Debian some years ago. Operating system, Windows, Android, and Debian. Bootloader, UEFI, is easy to install. Supports kernel, mainline kernel supports, and KVM and VirtualBox supports, display and battery, and USB live boot on Debian. And this is hacking expensive tablet and operating system. And I recommended Windows tablet because iOS and BlackBerry is non-hack and no boot Linux. And Windows RT and Windows Phone can hack Windows mobile OS, but they not boot Linux. I think Windows Phone and Windows RT, no one make Linux kernel and Linux root file system, I think. The other tablet can install Debian on now, but Android tablet is difficult to install, I think developer only, but Windows tablet, everyone can install Debian. And this is used and junk tablet on Japan in 2018. And yellow line is single board computer and Windows tablet, and green line is Android, and the other Windows tablet. I recommended US $40 to US $100 tablet because Kobo Touch and Kindle Paperwhite is operated Debian, but this tablet spec, CPU spec too low and difficult to beginner. Next, and I here use tablet on Linux and this sentence. One sentence, computer school on tablet. Second, AI and IoT and sync client monitor. Next, TV and car navigations and Android and wine and stream Windows game and any other application and desktop, office, server, terminal and the other application. And next, let's install Linux and Debian. But some Linux Atom programs are caused by mainline kernel about 70 to 80, I think it. And today, Linux mainline kernel have out of Atom bugs now. And recently, Atom UEFI devices two types. And Intel PC is easy to install Linux distribution and type 1 UEFI 32-bit and like 8-inch Windows tablet and stick PC. This machine based OS Windows 10 to 32-bit. Please check OS bit number. And UEFI 60-bit is notebook, Surface, AMD tablet, and GPD Win and GPD Pocket. And please check based OS Windows 10, 60-bit home or professional. And this is GPD Win and GPD Pocket, my test. And Debian and the other distribution operating now, but this machine have black screen bug and Intel GPU have a lot of Atom bug. So you can not boot on Intel graphics. So if you want to boot, need grab and this grab option. And Surface 3, and this is Cherry Trail Atom devices. Surface 3 is supported kernel 4.8 and Debian 9.5 distribution. Mainline kernel Linux supports Surface 3 now. And this is Chinese inexpensive Windows tablet, UEFI 32-bit. But UEFI 32-bit have a lot of bugs, bootloader, and power control, and black screen problem ago. And this is AMD tablet that is testing now. Intel Atom has a lot of kernel bugs, but AMD tablet is like notebooks. UEFI 64-bit, and GPU is Radeon, and no Atom bugs now. So easy to install Debian on AMD tablet, but I recommended it. And this is Atom benchmarks on versus Core 5 and Raspberry Pi 0W. And Atom is as half as fast as Core I series on power mode. It is different CPU clocks on power mode. But battery mode is low clocks. If you mobile computing on battery mode, they are not so different, I think. Next, install Debian ISO for UEFI 32-bit tablet and requires Windows tablets and Windows USB memory. Install Debian Matrix ISO and USB, micro USB, and USB hub, USB keyboard, USB mouse, and USB wired LAN adapter or Wi-Fi LAN adapter. And this is a recently PC boot process on Windows and Linux. And old type, legacy BIOS type is not problem, 32-bit and 64-bit, but UEFI 32-bit is no boot problem. Hardware is 64-bit, UEFI is 32-bit, GRAV is 32-bit, and install ISO like Debian 64-bit, but 64-bit ISO not have grab 32-bit package and installer. But only Debian. Debian has multi-arc ISO. And this type is grab 32-bit and 64-bit auto-recommand, auto-check. So Debian supports all over the Windows tablet now. Please use install multi-arc ISO. And notebook and 64 UEFI bit is hardware 64-bit, UEFI 64-bit, grab to 64-bit, and Debian 64-bit. This is no problem. And install Debian multi-arc. Debian supports UEFI 32-bit and UEFI 64-bit on multi-arch. Please, one sentence, full charge Windows tablet, I recommend it. Second, download iOS file, and this is net installer only, 0.3, write ISO file about LibreOffice or DD command on USB memory. Secure boot off and boot from USB memory. And install Debian. And this is network installer over 2 hours. So please check your Windows tablet battery and full charge. And this is Debian storage versus bus testing. This is stable and stretch 9.5 and basta testing now. I recommended basta testing because basta testing is a newer kernel 4.16. Today, after upgrade 4.17.8. And GNOME have a lot of bugs on stretch and testing. And GNOME stretch is 3.22, have rotation bugs and a lot of bugs. But basta testing GNOME 3.28.3 fixed bugs now. I tested. And the older kernels and driver a lot of atom bugs now. So please, if you use basta testing and newer kernel and GNOME. And next, recommended model of T100TA. Debian is an official supported T100TA on this Debian official website. This model type is easy to install, few bugs, and some devices patched one hand, the other patch in Debian website. Thank you very much. Next, Atom has a lot of type of processor. An official supported Linux kernel on Atom is here. Old tablet and Atom, like legacy BIOS, Octrail and Celeron M is not problem now. But Octrail is not supposed Linux PowerVR. In Linux kernel, suppose PowerVR, but not 3E graphics is not supported now. And Clover Trail Z2760 series is not boot Linux and PowerVR. This processor is UEFI 32-bit and OS 32-bit. And next, Bay Trail and Cherry Trail and Apple Lake is boot Debian now. And this is mainline kernel changelog on Atom. I researched it. And 4.2 in stretch sensor and Surface 3 supported now. 4.10 Surface 3 and Surface 4 patch and black screen patch now. And 4.11 Intel Turbo Freeze bug fix now. And 4.13 Chinese tablet touchscreen name MSSL1680 is supporting some devices now. And next, 4.15 Meltdown and Spectra is fixed. 4.16 and passive mode fix, and screen shift mode fix, and GPD pocket fan supported, and some MSL 1680 touchscreen patch supported, and 4.18 GPD Win 2 controller support. This is ARM changelog mainline kernel. And this is driver on Windows tablet. This sentence, touch screen and camera and accelerator is different chips and different models. So I will check all over the Linux kernel and Debian now. But Wi-Fi and Bluetooth driver is Realtek and Broadcom only. So this is open source now. This is a touchscreen driver supported on Linux kernel. Touchscreen is different chip on different tablet models. This list check is my Windows tablet on Linux. And I check the 30 touchscreen driver, but one model, MSSL 1680. This use Chinese inexpensive tablet is not supposed Linux mainline kernel because rotation and screen size is need one device and one patch. So so if you want to use touchscreen in Chinese tablet, you need device driver patches, device driver trees now. And this is new drivers problem on kernel. New chips and new PC. And after patch driver and GitHub, and merged mainline kernel, like Debian testing, 3 months to 3 years. And released kernel is after 2 years, like Debian stretch. So if you can, if you want to new driver and new bug fix is newer mainline kernel on Windows tablet. And this is a Linux distribution on Windows tablet. And Debian supported Multi Arch ISO image supported UFI 32-bit and UFI 64-bit, but the other distribution is not supported UFI 32-bit now, only Fedora. So the other Linux distribution don't operate Windows tablet 32-bit UFI. This is bootloader on any other devices. Grab bootloader operating legacy BIOS and UEFI supported. And RaspberryPi operated UEFI support. But the other is ARM bootloader, Red Boot and U-Boot is not supposed now. This is CPU and hacking tool. Intel devices hacking app is UEFI Boot Manager. Hardware and ROM bootloader is UEFI and BIOS. But ARM device is not operating UEFI and BIOS. So this is use U-Boot bootloader and processor maker is protected now, but Realtek and Orwina and MediaTek and the other processor is not protected tablet and ROM bootloader. So if you want to write ROM bootloader to Linux kernel and root file system, you can boot Debian on other tablet, I think it. Next, hacking UEFI boot entry and NVRAM. UEFI is have NVRAM entry. This is ROM bootloader check and hard disk grab to bootloader. But UEFI NVRAM is only file path to boot entry. Edit Windows Easy UEFI and Linux UEFI boot manager and changed this path and setting at grab x64.efi and this is disk bootloader and boot to Debian. In this system is UEFI system. And this is next devices. I test Apollo Rex Windows tablet, but this device is not boot GraBTSU and Linux now. Apollo Rex tablet can boot on GraBTSU bootloader, so mainly Linux distribution use GraBTSU bootloader. This is no boot on it. Please replace from GraBTSU to RaspberryPi. And this is a disk bootloader like a GraB. Mac user have been installed Linux ago. It usually installed sudo apt install RaspberryPi. But this is not have installed ISO images. Debian installer is only to use GraBTSU bootloader, so need to change it. But no package is on ISO file, so overwrite RaspberryPi EFI file on change GraB X EFI files. And to write ISO file on USB memory and copy boot X EFI and RaspberryPi conf on EFI boot folder. Download and files and the website and copy it. And after boot, I'll find on UEFI and try select install and boot USB memory in images. But install is no problem. But problem is after reinstalled to reboot, not reboot now. And after copy UEFI boot folder, it. And changed UEFI boot entry, edit easy UEFI on Windows 10, like file path on RaspberryPi.efi. This is EFI entry is only file path. So, when reboot UEFI and UEFI bootloader entry, they can boot Apollo Rex. Next, try another sentence and try use various things. And I recommended GNOME on Debian. GNOME is very conforming tablet on Windows Manager. But GNOME on-screen keyboard have no tab key and no up keys. And because not in terminal, not auto-completed on terminal. So if you type if you want to use auto-complete on terminal, need use another on-screen keyboard now. Next, inexpensive tablet can paint graphics tablet on Debian. Some tablets supported writing pen pressure on Linux kernel, like Wacom, but this is supported Surface and few models. But inexpensive tablet like Yoga tablet is not supported pen pressure. But software, Debian and Wine can use Krita, Clip Studio, and the other paint applications. Linux kernel supported pen pressure now. And Windows Steam on Wine game. Windows Steam and game on Wine 32-bit and .NET Framework 4. A lot of games operate on Wine. Steam is not protected. And keyboard is Antmicro supported keyboard emulation on gamepad. And the other hacking another ARM tablet, Debian of Kobo 2011. Debian on Kindle, Paperwhite, 2013. And Debian Ubuntu on Asus tablet, TF100 is Tegra devices in 20 and Ubuntu on Nexus series. Next, install Android on Debian and Dual Boot. Install Debian. Install Android on Debian need RPM files only. At Android website is provided RPM file images. If you want to dual boot Debian and Android, command line sudo apt install align and sudo align and Android and RPM files only. This is easy to install, no partition and no UEFI bootloader, dual boot on Debian. Please test it. And this is no issue on Atom bugs. Touch screen, different angle and rotations. Likewise, this is a GPDB and the other tablet. And black screen on Intel GPU. And no boot GTM on Intel GPD. And automatic suspend on GNU, but in Debian Buster is fixed, I think it. And this is known as 8-point black screen GPU bugs on some Atom devices, and some Bluetooth chip is not matched in mainline kernel, and rotation and inversion bugs on some touch screen, and some MSL1680 touch screen device isn't matched yet. Need screen resolution on kernel device trees. And can't use camera and GPS chip in tablet devices. And some distribution, no boot and systemd Atom bugs. 7, the other distribution is not supposed to UEFI 32-bit and operated only Debian. And 2, old kernels have a lot of bugs like the other distribution. Please use newer mainline kernel 4.60 or 4.18. And conclusion, easy to boot Debian on inexpensive Windows tablet. Everyone can use and hack tablet in your color, and more inexpensive than Raspberry Pi 2 and 3. More improve newer kernel on Windows tablet. Atom have kernels have a lot of bugs now, and newer mainline kernel is less kernel bugs and more drivers now. And Debian is supported UEFI 32-bit and 64-bit and all Windows tablet now. Everyone easy to install a lot of Windows tablet. And Apple Lake is newer tablet can boot Linux, but Gemini Lake tablet, I don't test Linux test now. So everyone can hack on Windows tablet on your car. Let's install Linux Debian on tablet. Finally, Debian GNU Linux is most advanced Linux distribution on tablet. Thank you, Debian, and that's all for. Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you for a very comprehensive talk. I've gained a lot of information regarding my next device. So I have a question. Recently, I think there is a common feeling that Intel CPUs are, or x86 CPUs are a bit more power hungry.
Yes.
So compared to ARM, how good are the batteries life go on these tablets?
Yes, so I think so.
So is it comparable or still need to be improved?
I think so. It, you say Android tablet is low power and CPU specs. And
battery life.
Battery life. Yes. Intel devices low battery life. You say I think so. It, but battery life is Linux kernel and. Not dependent processor, I think it. So display change the display and SSD, hard disk, and the other power CPU power and other point, I think it. So you say ARM device is low power battery, I think it.
Thanks.
So this is more like a situational questions. So I see you try to dual boot Debian and also Android OS. For Windows system, for Intel-based platform. I wonder, have you ever tried? There's a project called MBOS. MBOS is an open source project. It's licensed under GPL v3. And the idea is it allows you to run Android application on the on a Linux desktop. So the requirement is you need to install a shared memory kernel module and also the binder kernel module. And it allows you to create Android in a container using LSC. So using MBOS, you will be able to launch Android application in the desktop. So you don't need to do the dual boot anymore. You can launch Android on the desktop, in this desktop. Have you ever tried it? MBOS.
It is a difficult question.
No, it's not a question. It's like it's a suggestion. Maybe we can try it on Debian because right now, I think MBOS is available on Arch Linux and also Ubuntu, but it's not learned in Debian Archive yet. So maybe this is something we want to try.
Yeah. Okay.
And we can discuss after.
Okay. I think Ubuntu is very, very I use Ubuntu now, so after that.
Which tablet is the best for Debian right now?
Oh. I recommended Surface Intel model and this model, Yoga tablet in Windows type.
Say the name again, please.
And Yoga tablet to on Windows model.
So it feels like Lenovo, right?
Lenovo. But Linux mainline kernel supports only Surface model. If you have Surface model, no bug and no problem on Debian.
I remembered on one of your slides, you said AMD CPUs has better Linux support and driver support than Atom CPUs.
Yes.
So do you have some recommendation for AMD tablets?
AMD tablets are recommendation because AMD tablet is not tablet style, like notebook style.
I see.
This model have no GPU bugs on Radeon. But this mod type is and not charged USB 5 volt, I think it. Any other question?
So my question about
please go to the
microphone. Thank you.
Yes.
So I asked about tablets. What is your favorite small laptop for Debian?
Oh,
this one on your podium? No, the
yes. PDF type like GPD Pocket is and this type is easy to install Debian, but Atom type has a lot of bug.
Okay.
No. Boot and no GPU in Debian and the other Linux. So I recommended Core M processor and AMD processor. Next generation GPD Win 2 and GPD Pocket 2 is not Atom, and I recommended it on Debian.
I think there's a lot of information I will need to digest. So I'll need to study for your provided materials. So do you have a website or blog for future reference? Oh, great. Oh, thank you, sorry.
This is my website and SlideShare. And please, check hashtag DebConf 18 on Twitter. Please search it. Any one question? That's all. Thank you very much.